In this video, we're shown a standing wave on a string, and this has been excited by some kind of mechanical oscillating device here at the ends. In practice, this is a speaker-like device with a metal rod attached to it. You hook it onto the string. And we're told the length of the string is 1.8 meters, and we notice that the standing wave we're looking at has four antinodes, and we're told the frequency of oscillation that excited this standing wave is 30 hertz, and then the string is tensioned by draping it over a pulley and hanging a mass of 350 grams off of it. So in part A, we're asked to find the fundamental frequency for the string. And in a previous video, we showed that all resonant frequencies on the string are multiples of a fundamental frequency, the lowest one. So that fundamental mode looks like this. That's where the middle of the string wiggles up and down as the only antinode. That's our n equals 1 case. And then if I examine the higher harmonics, what I'm trying to do is figure out which harmonic I'm looking at here. The n equals 2 case is when you have two antinodes. And finally, we get to the fourth harmonic, which is the one that we're actually looking at in this problem. So we can say that F4, the frequency of the fourth harmonic, is equal to 4 times the frequency of the fundamental. So the frequency of the fundamental is just the frequency of the fourth harmonic divided by 4. That's 30 hertz over 4. And I find that the frequency of the fundamental for this string is 7.5 hertz. So what this means is if we tune our oscillator to 7.5 hertz, we'll just see the center of the string flopping up and down as the only antinode. In part B, we're asked to compute the linear density of the string. And there are two parts coming together in this question. First of all, the wave speed is related to the frequency and the wavelength by V equals F lambda. And I'll post a link real quick to the video where that was first introduced. And second, the wave speed is related to the tension in the string and the linear density of the string by square root T over mu, where mu is the linear density. And I'll post a link to the video where that was first introduced as well. Now, linear density is kind of a strange quantity. Its units are kilograms per meter. And this is just a way of talking about how heavy a string or a rope is. How many kilograms does it have for every meter? So you can imagine like a heavy chain might be 2 kilograms per meter of chain. So that's the thing we're after in this problem for this string. And I can go ahead and find the wave speed using frequency times wavelength. And I have a couple choices here. I can just go ahead and use the waves that I'm looking at in the original setup of the problem. And what I notice is that an entire wavelength fits on half the string. And that has a length of 0.9 meters. So that's lambda for the fourth harmonic. And then the frequency for the fourth harmonic was 30 hertz. So I can take 30 hertz times 0.9 meters. And I get a wave speed of 27 meters per second. Now that wave speed is going to be the same for every harmonic that we find, and it's determined by how much tension we put on the string and how heavy the string is. So I think I'll go ahead and get the tension on the string right now. And this thing is tensioned by hanging a mass off of it, and the mass is not accelerating. And that means the force of gravity down on this thing is equal to the tension in the string. And if I compute mg, I need to put the mass in the right units, so 0.350 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 3.43 newtons. Okay, now I have the wave speed and I have the tension. The only unknown in that second equation is the linear density. And I'm gonna go ahead and solve for this symbolically. I'm gonna square both sides and I get V squared is T over mu. Multiply both sides by mu and divide by V squared. And I get that mu is T over V squared. And we plug in our tension, 3.43 newtons. Divide by the square of the wave speed, so 27 meters per second all squared. And when I crunch the numbers, I get 0.00471 kilograms per meter. It's probably more appropriate to state that in grams per meter. So I get 4.71 grams per meter. And that sounds pretty reasonable for like a guitar string, for example. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.